This video will be about the subject of the organic certification. Now I'll be doing a few videos on this subject because it's it can't all be covered in one video. And we'll start with a look at the certificate from an international certification agency certifying that the farm is organic. They normally certify and give this kind of certificate. And inside the certificate, it's normally valid for 1 year. And from the date of inception, it takes 5 years of under certification, that is in the process. And then from the 5th year onwards, whatever you grows inside the farm is considered to be certified organic. So 5 year waiting period is normally a put off for many people. You have to spend money, you have to maintain a lot of documentation. And so this is how those certificates look. They can have the product number. Each item that is grown in the farm has a product number and then the botanical name of that. And like that, it's listed out. Of course, this is one of the most biodiverse garden in the world. So I'm having almost 400 species listed here, and everything is there. So it's a collection center and a model garden. And of course, goes without saying, if it's just a private garden, it's not worth certifying because it costs so much money. Every year you have to spend 20,000 to 25,000 rupees to certify. And if some company has promised to buy your material and they are saying give it certified and they are going to pay for the certification charges, then it's worthwhile for a smaller farmer. Spending our own money and doing this certification is not viable because the local customers who buy are not really interested in any certificate. It's word of mouth and reputation. And then if you're doing internationally, if your customer is buying, then they ask for these certificates. Because enormous fraud also happens in these certificates. Some of them are all giving easily without much inspection. Some of the certifying agencies are very strict. And by and large, I found the European certifying agencies are having high standard. That IMO, I think from Switzerland, each country has its own certifying body. And that German, the Biodynamic Association. Our garden is certified by the Dutch company called Control Union. We are one of their first customer in 1990. When I started all this organic thing, we certified. And we're one of the first Indian garden to get certified. Now, if a decision is taken to certify the garden, better to tie up with someone who is going to buy whatever you grow, and then you grow against their requirement, against a fixed price. So now let's take a look at some of the important books. Now whether you are certifying or not, it's a good idea to maintain books, because then over the years you can see what all you have done, what all has come out of the farm. And it's a system, you can also calculate your profitability. So it brings in clarity and everything if you maintain good books. And as per the certification rules, international rules, there are 2-3 books to be maintained by the farmer. The first book is the cultivation book, that is every day we'll write down what all work has been done in the farm. So this is the cultivation book. You can get it printed somewhere nearby. And you have serial number, date. Write the date of that day. Suppose you did work on onions, you can write onion. And then the section of the garden, plot number, area. And then the manure quantity, if you added manure. If you're pesticided, we don't pesticide, so it's always blank. Seeds and all. So what work is done, cultivation book is one book that has to be maintained every day. If no cultivation is done on a day, you just leave it blank, but you write the date and write blank. Then there's a second book where the input is put in. So this is the second book is input output, where you write when it material that comes into the farm is written down, and the material that goes out is written down. And this is called a harvesting book, where whenever we harvest, from which block it has been harvested, how much quantity, and then sending, it has to be accompanied by a documentation from the day of planting till the day of dispatch. So in this harvesting book, again serial number, date, crop, you write the name, and then maintain it month after month. Over the years you'll get a, you can total up these harvest quantities and see how the yield is increasing, and it's useful for the profitability calculation also. Then the third book is called outward book. That is, when anything leaves the farm, we have to maintain it. So for example, 4-11-11, material was dispatched to the customer, and material was Brahmi, that's at Bakkappa Manevi, and then the DC number and lot number, quantity was 60 kgs. So this is how the outward book is maintained. Now, if I sum it up in a nutshell, you need one book where you may write down what all work has been done, and one book where anything external item input that is coming into the farm is written, seeds, some manure and some tools, and anything that comes into the farm you write in that input book, and an output book where anything that goes out of the farm is written down. That's all, 3-4 books. But it's every day it has to be done. This is, and our stock transfer note. Sometimes we harvest it on a particular day, and then it's semi-dried here, so 2-3 days it stays in the farm. So when it goes out of the farm, there's a stock transfer note is made, and then it's maintained like this. All these books will be inspected by the International Certificate Agency. Normally twice a year, they come twice a year and then see whether everything is maintained. And in the beginning of every year, you have to give a crop plan. What exactly you are planning to grow in the farm? How much output is likely to come? So you can't just tell lies and say we grew 500 kgs of this, 300 kgs of that as they want. It has to be part of the annual plan. At the end of the year, somewhat nearby to that quantity what you projected will be come out of the farm. So they can prevent cheating, and then maintain the correct quantities. So in the beginning of the year you make a annual plan, and throughout the year whatever comes in is recorded, whatever goes out is recorded, and whatever work that is done inside the farm is recorded. You maintain it, and then you pay those certifying agencies for the inspection charges, they'll give you a certificate. Then you can contact any of the organic company of the your area and tell them that, listen, I have certified farm. What exactly you want me to grow? And you can make agreement with them and supply them. For this garden, such an arrangement is there with Kandige Organic. Company has supported with by buying the content, whatever we grow, because prices are high, it's expensive. Without the company's support, you can't do this kind of herb cultivation. Because after growing, and then there's no customer, and then you have to throw away the herbs, that's all depressing and loss-making. So never grow stuff unless somebody has promised to buy it, and the price is known, and it's a reliable company who keeps their word. So that's a few words on this organic certification. Now, when the international certifying agency's representative comes to visit the farm, they like to come by surprise often. And first they will inspect the books, see whether everything is in order. And then they will inspect your storeroom to see whether some of these dishonest organic farmers, they'd have hidden away some pesticide or something in the storeroom. So they'll visit there and take a look whether we are absolutely foolish and kept something in the and then they also walk around the farm seeing whether any old pesticide cans and fertilizer packets and all are lying anywhere here and there as a giveaway sign. And of course they use their discretion and judgment when they meet the farmer and to see what exactly they're doing. However, there is plenty of scope, or like any other activity, if a determined cheater is there, they can find some way around the system. But by and large, it's easy to make out if an organic garden is really organic, because you will not see any insects in the spray. When I go into an organic garden, I don't require any certificate to find out whether it's organic or not. I just see the insect life that is there. A few sprays and everything will be vanished. If you go into a garden and don't see any insects, you can be sure they are lying. Plenty of ants, butterflies, little birds and all have to be there in an organic farm. If they are missing, they have been sprayed off. So that's what I'd use. But people like to have a certificate, so we get this certificate.